Welcome to GRBC. Kids, I'm so happy to have each and every one of y'all here with us today. Let's get started with a word of prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you so much for this day. We thank you so much for your many blessings, answered prayers, even unanswered prayers. Lord, we just lift this lesson up to you, and Lord, I pray for strength and guidance as I talk about my dad. Already I'm losing it. Lord, just please be with us, guide, protect, and keep us safe. In Jesus' name I do pray, amen. All right, y'all, just as an announcement, starting on June 6th, we have a children's church coming back in Sunday school, and I look forward to seeing each and every one of y'all here in person. We also have, starting on July the 26th through July the 30th, we have VBS Destination Dig, Unearthing the Truth About Jesus. It is going to be online, so you can get the lessons through YouTube, the website, and Facebook. So this coming Sunday is Father's Day, where we take time to honor our fathers. So I want you to ask, how do you describe your father? There are so many words that can be used. I personally can say in my dad, loving, head of the home, strong, God-fearing, man of his word, thoughtful, hardworking, and willing to listen. Now, my dad is not perfect. In fact, no father is except for our Heavenly Father. I would like to tell you some more about my dad, though. Now, I could just tell you some random information like he grew up in Durham. He went to the Air Force. He worked at Central Prison. He met my mom while he was in the Air Force, going back a little bit. And he also worked for IBM. Now, allow me to start off by saying I am a PK, which means preacher's kid. Now, most PKs are raised with their father already being in the ministry. My sister and I were not. Growing up, our dad worked security at IBM. He was a Sunday school teacher and the chairman of the board. He wore many hats. I have been blessed in that I have had the opportunity to watch how the Lord has worked in and changed my dad's life. I used to watch my dad prepare his Sunday school lessons at the kitchen table. He would take his Bible and quarterly and would look up the information for the lessons. There was one time that he was having difficulty finding a passage in the book of Isaiah. He didn't ask for help, but Mom, Robin, and I each grabbed our Bible, sat down at the kitchen table, and helped him to search for that passage. I remember him looking up at us and just smiling. Another time, when church had been canceled due to snow, we sat down at the kitchen table and had our own church, with the sermon being the Sunday school lesson he was going to teach. Years went by, and Dad continued to teach Sunday school. The Lord was continually working on him and through him. He felt the calling of God when I was 18 and a senior in high school. He became a lay minister, and 1 year later, he was ordained. Becoming a minister hasn't been a barrel of laughs or easy. However, each of those difficult times has strengthened him and allow him to use those lessons to help others in the ministry or help others in his congregation. As of today, my dad has been in the ministry for over 33 years and is still going strong. As God works in him and through him, there is no telling what he has in store for him or me, or for that matter, as I watch him go on this journey. Our Heavenly Father loves each and every one of us. He wants the best for us, the best out of us. Just like my dad, are you willing to let God walk in you, through you? Just pray to him to help you and lead you to do what he wants you to do. I know this is a short lesson, but, you know, all in all, I just pray that all dads have a happy Father's Day. And I love you, Daddy.